started off by cutting 2 of fabric from the satin and cutting 4 of fabric from the canvas. Then basted the satin layer to the canvas strengthening layer. And as I basted the satin, I was sure to put that 90s Nickelodeon TV show print to the inside. I cut the facing for the loop side of the busk. Begin pinning the corset pieces together. My only advice in pinning the pieces together is being diligent in cutting out all the pattern markings, also known as arrows. These are lifesavers when it comes to pinning the pieces together. I sewed the corset together using a 1/4-inch seam allowance. Using hammy, I iron open the seams of the corset. I should have done this before I assembled the corset pieces, but I'm using the pattern pieces to mark the waistline across all the pieces. Then then using my iron, I iron it in half. The reason for this is to create a crease down the center of the ribbon, so I can lay the ribbon down the center of my pencil markings. Roughly, I align the crease of the ribbon with the penciled waistline markings across all the corset panels. With needle and thread, I basted the waist stay to the seam allowance where I had previously marked the waistline. Carefully stitch the waist stay in place, taking care not to let any of your stitches show from the right side of the corset. I trace the busk to create a stencil, skipping over the sections where the loops will protrude from the seam. Then I iron open the seam for the loop side of the facing. I inset the loops in the spaces of the seam, chalking the busk as deep and tight as possible and pinning it into place. I basted the busk with a matching thread, but any thread will do. These can be messy because they will be taken out later. For the knob side of the corset, I pinned the facing, sewed it using a 1/4 inch seam allowance, and pressed the seam open. If you are wondering why I chose to roll up and cram the corset under the throat of the machine, it's because I always want to be sure that I am sewing from the top edge to the bottom edge and not vice versa. Always sewing in one direction ensures that I'm not sewing across the warp and the weft in two different directions, which can warp the panels or boning channels and be unsightly. Lining up the top and bottom edges of the corset, I mark the position where the knobs will be. Stupidly, I grabbed a Sharpie to mark the knob placement, which I can't get out of the fabric later. So don't be like me and be sure to mark with a fabric marker or disappearing ink. Finally, I invested in an awl, and this tool certainly is the one for the job. I had never actually used an awl before and ended up pushing the awl too deeply into the fabric for a few of the holes, tearing the delicate satin in the process. Since the satin is pretty delicate, I decided it was a good idea to use fray check on the fabric around the knobs. As I'm waiting for the fray check to dry, I grab some thread and baste it along the edge of the busk. Again, these stitches don't have to be neat because they will be removed later. I needed to make some bias binding to bind the top and bottom of the corset. On this scrap of fabric, I'm trying to find the bias, which is usually on the diagonal from the salvage edge. I set about marking the fabric for the bias strips. I personally like a wide, meaty binding on my corsets or stays. I like to think the wider binding is the framing for my corset portrait. Okay, that sounded better in my head, but hopefully you get the idea. With a bias tape maker, I fed the satin into the opening, let it do its folding thing, and ironed the satin into position. I sewed the center back seam closest to the eyelets on both sides of the corset to finish the center back edges. I then switched my attention back to the basque. With my zipper foot, I sewed as close as possible to the edge of the basque without breaking my needle. Thank you. With a marker, I marked the boning channels on the lining side of the corset. Off camera, I thread marked all the boning channels, then top stitched them, backstitching at the top of the corset and backstitching again at the bottom, then clipping my threads. But most importantly, I'm consistently sewing the channels from one direction only. I use half-inch wide plastic zip ties for the boning. With an extra piece of boning, I use my zipper foot to sew a channel on either side of the previous thread-marked lines. To finish the inside of the corset, I folded over the 90s Nickelodeon lining, tucking it under the busk facing, pinning the facing down. With purple thread, I slip stitched the facing to the lining. You may be wondering why I didn't just sew it with a machine. I didn't want any visible top stitching unless it was a boning channel. I repeated this for the facing on the other side of the corset. I top stitched a quarter of an inch away from the raw edge of the corset, closing the boning channels, then trimmed the bottom of the corset in preparation for bias binding. Then I start on the boning. I'm using half-inch wide plastic zip ties, cutting them to length. I cut off the pointy tip, snipping off the sharp corners to make them blunter. I mark them half-inch shorter than the raw edge of the corset. Thank you. And this is me cutting out more binding and hoping to heck I have enough to bind the entire corset. These little scraps are literally all I have left of this fabric. And at this point, I wasn't sure I would actually have enough. That's what I get for using scraps from my stash. Off camera, I prepped a total of 4 spiral steel bones, 2 each for the lacing panels. I sewed these into channels the same way I did the plastic ones. It's 1 inch apart. Each panel has 12 eyelets. Here you can see me embroidering the last one. I'm using 3 strands of purple embroidery thread to sew the eyelets. I was playing around with the number of threads when sewing them, and I think I prefer 2 strand eyelets. I believe the eyelets would have been done a bit faster, especially if I didn't have an attention-demanding furry critter standing in the way of progress. Thank you. Years ago, I made this Regency hat out of the same purple satin I'm using for this corset, but sadly, it's on the chopping block. I no longer have a dress to wear with this hat, and I'm in desperate need of this fabric, so I'm dismantling this hat, salvaging all the decorations for any future projects. And I repeated the process of making bias tape, marking the horizontal grain line, and cutting the bias strips. I won't go into further depth about making bias tape because I know you've seen me do it plenty of times. Somehow, I didn't manage to catch myself on film finishing the binding, so here's the corset in all its glory.